Hello, Transformer fans, this is Prime92, and today I'll be looking at the world's smallest clear version of Generation 1 Soundwave. Now, this is a knockoff. I don't know, you can probably tell. If you know anything about world's smallest, I don't know if they ever made a Soundwave one. You can get this. I got it on eBay. You can also get it in the normal Soundwave colors, which I might get now. And I think Sound Blaster colors from the Japanese Headmaster series, where he's basically black instead of blue. And it does come in this nice protective shell, which is good. And it'll keep it nice and safe, because it is clear. Clear plastic, as I've said before, is brittle compared to normal plastic, and it is very small as it is. So it's nice, it won't get lost. And man, it is so freaking tiny. Actually, I'll compare it to some of these other people might have, the Legends Optimus Prime. Yep. That is small. Even for a world's smallest, this is really small. So small, I'll have to zoom in to actually do it justice now. You can see it has the Decepticon logo there, and the normal detailing on the front, and it has, I got rewind, fast forward, play, eject, pause, I think it is. So yeah, all the right buttons. You got the head there. I don't know, can you rotate it? No, it's on a hinge. I don't want to break it. But anyways, you can transform it, almost like the original. Bring the legs down, straighten them, rotate. And it does have little feet. Just going to kind of push it in from the back to try to get it out. Just little teeny feet. I wasn't even sure if they were there, because being all clear, you couldn't see it distinguished from the plastic. From like, this would be normally like a white or a silver compared to the blue leg. So it's hard to tell if they're actually there or not. The arms just come out. I'm pretty sure on the original, the arms would come down with a slider, but it's one piece. And then head goes up. And that is Soundwave. And man, it's so good. Even has an opening tape deck. I can't imagine ever having a small tape to go in there. A world's smallest laser beak or Ravage? Oh my god. That'd be so small. And it's nice, it has a little tab so you can actually get it up from the top. A little indent there. And he does have articulation. The arms will rotate. And they can bend at the elbow. And the legs can go forwards and rotate some. And bend the wrong way at the knee. And the feet can go down. So he does have some articulation. Surprisingly, the legs are a little loose because they are ball joints. But you know what? I can live with that. Now, I was wondering, because when I got this thing, and I saw this compartment, I didn't realize it was in, like, it was very little space there. I thought it would have accessories there, but it didn't have any accessories. I'm like, oh, that sucks. He doesn't have the shoulder cannon or the handgun. Then I remembered, they're stored in the backpack as batteries, and they're exactly the same. Little guns. That is awesome. Now, the thing is, you have to get them a certain way. It seems that... Oh my god, don't drop it. Oh, that was close. A little indents right here. Kind of go into spots right here. So that they'll actually fit. Because if you can't get them like that, the cover won't go back on. So, just put... They're both exactly the same. Just put one on the hole in the shoulder, and then one in the hand, just trying to be careful. It is clear, like I said, I don't want to break anything. I just got it like 20 minutes ago, and there it is. This is awesome. I love this thing. It is so tiny, but it is so detailed. If I could maybe, oops, get my hand behind it and show you some more detail there. Very nicely detailed. For being minuscule. Now, some more size comparisons. Here he is with Legends Starscream. Yeah, he's half the size. And for my Gundam friends, Unicorn SD. Yeah. Unicorn can actually use him as a boombox, pretty much. So yeah, this thing I got on eBay, I think I said before, and I paid, I think it was $8 for it, 8 or 10, and that was with the free shipping. And I totally recommend it. This thing is awesome in any version. I just got the clear because it was different, and I like clear. But I kind of want to get the other versions too. It is so small, even in terms of world smallest, it is really small. And it's just really different to have, and it's pretty solid. The plastic feels pretty good. And it's very detailed. So yeah, if you want to get this, I totally recommend it. If you're like me, you never had an original, and you like a little teeny thing like this just to have you easily stick in your pocket without a problem. Or just have it just because it's awesome. It's different. So yeah, that's about it. And I'll